Music Buzz Live Radio here on World Viral TV. We are powered by Evergreen Apothecary. As always, my name is Moose. Thank you very much for tuning in this evening. We've got an exciting program tonight. The boys from Resonance coming in here in about a half an hour. We're going to be talking new album. We're going to be talking upcoming shows, including the CD release party. Chris, what's going on this weekend? I know we got Methods.
Yeah, that was what you were just listening to if you were tuning in before we dropped in. That was Methods. They're playing Friday night with High Five. Who else is on that show?
Don White Verse, Fudge. We've had a couple times. White Fudge.
Yeah, that should be sick.
And the Bandwagon 5 winner, Chris Zell, is also on that bill. That's going to be a great night.
Yeah, and then Saturday we got Otis Taylor, the blues legend, with Hazel Miller and the Bluesinators. So I'm going to be here both nights. And
I'll be here Friday. Saturday I got to go to a wedding.
Yeah?
Which kind of sucks.
No, that really sucks.
Yeah. I mean, it's like my sixth wedding
are lame.
This summer. Insane.
Who do we have on the couch?
Who do we have on the couch? Go ahead and introduce yourself.
By entering, you acknowledge that you're being filmed. So.
Oh wow! Well, hello there. I'm Bella Rage. I was brought in tonight just to sit in and maybe co-host a little bit, do some interviews.
Cool. Very cool.
Right on.
Very cool.
We can work with that. That's awesome. We're gonna have a full studio as always in here. We got Hack It or Axe It and Motel Minute coming up. Just about 7 o'clock, we're going to be kicking those off with the Cannabis Kitty. We're going to be talking to them about upcoming business venture, maybe, upcoming name. I don't know.
Don't spill the beans, homie.
All right. Well, we'll be back here in just a couple of minutes. We got a brand new music video for you from Kindub, so stick around. This is World Viral TV.
And this right here is Anxious.
Anxious, baby. Yeah. Ballistic 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. Says thou shalt fear no man but God, but damn it's hard when the devil playing his card. You either claim you insane or they slam the bars. Last stand on the cross in the land of the lost. I'm a man, I'm a boss, I'ma battle the depths. I'ma walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I'ma blast till there ain't no other ammo is left. I'ma handle scandals and threats, then abandon my flesh. I'm just expanding my set. My spirit's calmer than it's ever been. People been telling me my whole life that I'll never win. Others say I better win. Tip top, heaven sent. Touchdown, underground, hip hop veteran. Buying what I'm selling's not a typical sale. I got centrifugal forces forcing open indivisible jails. Spiritual takes over when physical fails. I met God from putting Yale on a digital scale. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. Y'all already know my steelo. I'm flyer than the ego. Looking down into the eyes of the devil and see the evil. I go my own way like Carlito. Plus half these rappers is actors like Johnny Depp and Al Pacino. What you think I sing for? I'm trying to get my story told. This could be my theme song. I could call it Glory Road. They look hard on the outside, but they soft on the inside like an Oreo. I'm taking over for a decade like the Eggman 80s and plaguing through the villages until there's anxious babies. I see my homeboys in the cut blazing buds and all my junkie homies on the corner craving drugs. I got respect for every person, every people. I ain't better than no one and I ain't worse than them either. This verse about to be done. Keep it on the down low. This is how you count dough. Count dough. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 48,000 on the scale. That's the 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo. 8th, half ounce, quarter pound, and a kilo.
my treasure, drinking for pleasure. Let me show you the way, please stay a while. Promise me you'll smile, I'll show you some freedom, give you some style, give you that thing in your walk, getting everyone to talk about your bad habits, taking slap like hits, making you wish you never were taught to rock like this. Death kiss to euphoria, we'll need the lower year to get you through the door before your own glory. It's taken from yourself, down as in the flow, and you're mowing everyone else, cause you failed the test. Trucks making shit a mess, can't confess cause your lips can't move, just need some rest, cause you'll be praying to the porcelain soon. Nobody liking your tune, puking toxic fumes, death clowns staring you down, making animal balloons. These drugs are what you choose, bright circus afternoon, sweating meth bullets in the middle of your room. Have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. Staying high in Soberville takes a skill hard to fulfill, bringing power from your will. Spilt milk when you rebuild, clear your visibilities, your insecurities, adaptabilities, to finally see what you should be seeing, what you should be feeding from. Overstrong anal attitude amplifying contributes to get yourself a prostitute. You got the money, can you execute your mission? How much did you pay for that ambition? Ammunition, did you ask your mom's permission? Dude, you got in lockdown position, hard bound, fucked up, all the newfound sight indecisions, overrun by religion, a rough draft of your life, trying to make all your revisions, so the description of your vision measures up that life's remission. But you're wishing as you're pissing down the drain of superstition, fishing in the lakes of pain and inhibition, insufficient exposition of the modern day musician. Have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. To attack, living in this attic leaves a hot feeling black, hopeless and dopeless, sober life is whack, drink till I pass out, never looking back, last glance, I had a chance to dance, shaking life's roots, ripping up all plants, clapped out all stars, claiming a stance, standing up to death, it's time to face the facts, live life to die, spread your wings and fly, swallow your surrender, give the truth a try. Goodbye to good guys, hello to french fries, ketchup and mustard, spiders and horse flies. Caught in the web, you're paralyzed, motionless, crippled, triple traumatized. Lay down in your grave, close your eyes, your death is the best hope too. Have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky. You gotta have fun before you die, push it to the limit, cause the limit is the sky.
Music Buzz Live Radio here on World Viral TV. My name is Lewis. Thank you so much for joining us. We are powered, as always, by Evergreen Apothecary, 1568 South Broadway, just two doors north of us here. The best deals in town.
You guys still have a $90.
Dude, we have a $99 ounce special going on right now.
120 out the door.
120 after tax out the door.
That's crazy.
It's like limited time, though. It's only going to be around for maybe like 7 to 10 more days, I would say, depending on how fast we go through what we're getting
through. Yeah, how fast it goes. Right on. All right, so we have a special guest in studio tonight, Bella. And from what I understand, you're usually in my position asking the questions.
Yes, that's actually true.
All right, let's get the lowdown on your program and what your background is.
A little bit about myself. I'm a former beauty pageant queen
that
turned into an alternative model, and from then I started doing booking bands and things of that nature. Got to know a few people in the industry and realized maybe I shouldn't just be booking bands. Maybe I should be trying to tell a little bit about their stories. Okay. So I started writing journalism. And I worked for a local tattoo magazine, Inkspired magazine here in Denver. And basically just started interviewing bands for a living. Cool. Many bands, and never on the radio. I've made a couple of appearances here and there, but no, not certainly anything like you.
Okay. Let's hear, we've interviewed, we do a lot of bands. It's Colorado Music Buzz. I've talked to lots and lots of bands and heard a lot of stupid shit. You got any good stories you care to share from any of these guys? Any crazy?
She was at Riot Fest too.
Yeah, oh, you were at Riot Fest. Cool.
Yeah, shoot. I actually just finished covering Riot Fest.
Cool. Riot Fest was awesome.
Well, I guess I could say without hopefully being hit by 1,000 bricks. I love Fat Mike and I love NoFX. They're absolutely my favorite band.
It's my favorite band too.
It is actually Tim's favorite band.
Right.
Yep. Long time.
But he is a little bit like me, so what that means is I'm a little bit of an asshole, so...
Yeah, I think Fat Mike can fall in that
Mike
category.
So Fat Mike is a little bit of an asshole, which just makes me love him a little bit more, I think. As far as, like, interesting stories or anything, it's more from the crowd, I would say. Yeah, yeah, definitely. Not too many bands getting in trouble there.
God, but, everybody had their shit together.
A lot of crowd involvement, yeah.
Yeah, it was a party. I mean, God, you get people drunk and make them listen to punk rock for 3 days straight. There were a lot of drunk people. Yeah.
A lot of drunk people.
That's to be expected, right?
I was one of them.
Yeah.
Right here.
Oh, drunk people were like my best friends for some reason. At any show I go to, it's like they come out of the woodworks and turn around and see me, and they're all over me, like, hey, I haven't seen you in forever, and wow, I never even realized we met, but all right.
That's cool. You got anything coming up you want to talk about? Anything fun to share? Anything you're stoked on? Any shows? Any events?
Well, I guess right now, the one that's certainly coming up closest would be the 15th annual Victorian Fetish Bowl.
Okay.
Kevin Larson puts it on every year.
Always like
Kevin. And I typically work that ball as well. But my friend does most of the planning for the event. So the 15th annual Victorian Fetish Bowl, that'll be October 18th. And of course, it's always held at the same place. I believe it's the Diamond Cabaret here in downtown Denver.
Right on.
Yeah, for sure. So that's definitely my next up and coming event. I was going to talk about being on here with you guys.
It's great to have you on here.
Please forgive me. I'm a little nervous. It's a double sticker shock here.
We're all total geeked out. Yeah, yeah. It is what it is. It's interesting because you're coming down the stairs of Herman's and then you walk in and this is not what you're expecting to see.
No,
definitely not. No. Whenever I was greeted at the door, I explained why I was here and go on downstairs. Sure.
It's nice that that's how it is now. Like everybody's like, just go downstairs.
Just go downstairs and I walk right into this, which is phenomenal. Yeah. You know, it's absolutely great. I'm not going to complain.
Right? Could be a lot worse, that's for sure. Are you originally from here?
No.
Let's hear about where you're a transplant.
I'd rather not say again at
Texas?
The risk of yes. You called me out and I just didn't want to get kicked off stage.
Yeah, it's all right.
I'm from Houston originally. Okay. Moved around quite a bit though, all over the United States.
Cool.
And of course finally a couple of years ago, I got my head straight, and I thought, hey, now why am I living in Texas when I can live in Colorado?
Right.
We have another girl on our staff, Heather, is from Texas, too. So
she is, and you talk to Heather for like a minute, you know she's from Dallas.
We're going
to
be calling her at 7:10 p.m. tonight.
Right away.
I try very hard to hide my accent.
Well, you do better than a lot, I will say that.
Yeah, for sure.
That's all a right. Cool. I checked your. I scoped you out online. That's a cool profile picture.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Bella Race.
Oh yeah, Rage.
Rage.
Bella Rage.
She's a public figure.
Those were from a few boudoir shoots that Andy Wynn did.
Okay.
Pretty
not
cool.
Too long ago. Yeah, and one was shot by Jennifer Gill.
Right.
Nice.
On.
Yeah.
Very fun.
It's always nice whenever people can make a girl feel pretty.
Isn't that the purpose of life?
Yeah. It's definitely one of them.
Sometimes it's not too hard, you know?
Yeah. All right. Well, while we're at it, let's show the new Kind Dub music video. This one just dropped yesterday. We are debuting it on ColoradoMusicBuzz.com, and we're going to show it to you right now. These boys are from up in Fort Collins, some of the best hip-hop in Colorado. Let's check them out.
Stop this, the money's on the mind. Type of passion keeps us making music all the time. Puffing on some purple, coughing up a couple rhymes. Line up a row of glasses on a steady buzz and grind. Jamming in the whip, mobbing with a pack of dimes. Regular occurrence when you're fucking with the kind. Type of beats and music you can't get up out your mind. Said it once before, so I'll say another time. Dirty South of Sea when we keeping them real high. Why drink and drive when you can smoke and fly? Can't stop this when you pursue your dreams. Nothing standing in the way of a couple kings. Hear it in your ears, it's a certain type of ring. Take a taste of this, it's some purple mixed with green. Now that you're on a level and you're leveling with me, let's get the party popping, ATL 303.
Oh, take it to the top, we love getting high, we like it drunk. Oh, take it to the top, pop another bottle, roll another blunt. Oh, take it to the top, throw up your hands, music never stops. Oh, this is just a start, and you know we're never gonna stop.
It's Friday, I've been riding round town, it's my day. Smiling without a frown, happiness without a doubt. Clouds of smoke come out my mouth. Chilling round town, rolling blunts with the know-how. It's like the Braves mix with the CO Rocks. Denver Nuggets flocking with the Atlanta Hawks. Kind of drops everything that's sounding hot. Styles of success, we gonna take it to the top. Said it's my day, and you know we getting down. Cruising in the ride while we listening to sounds. Picking up some ladies that be down to smoke a pound. Gotta roll them proper time to smoke them out. Passing baddies, chasing hits with double shots. Listen to the beat drop. Top notch liquor pumping when a couple bottles pop. The night is young, type of day that never stops.
Oh, take it to the top. We love getting high, we like getting drunk. Oh, take it to the top. Pop another bottle, roll another blunt. Oh, take it to the top. Throw up your hands, music never stops. Oh, this is just a start, and you know we're never gonna stop.
Throw up your hands. It's a celebration, party's waiting, why you hesitating? Take a sip of this, heavy blunts are in rotation. Take a break from your daily education. Chilling in the sun, it's a light vacation. Not a worry in your mind, cause the trees are blazing. Finish all the drinks, cause the shots we are not wasting. Take it to the top, you know we started in the basement. Never gonna stop, we take it to the top. Better get used to us because we rhyme a lot. Music that gets you pumped like gas every time we drop. Tell the bartenders about another round of shots. We can kick it till last call and smoke up all some props. This is the weekend and we're chilling on your block. Got some herb and some liquor and some ladies looking hot. So let's keep the party going cause it's never gonna stop.
Yeah, that was a pretty well done video. It's 100% DIY too. I think they did a pretty good job.
Sick, man.
Definitely representing like Colorado well.
Good life. Those good guys life. Actually did a coast, like they toured out east this summer.
Cool. Yeah, I dug that, man. Should have them send us the MP3s so we can rock.
Yeah,
that
I will. I want to get them into Herman's too. They did. They took third in Bandwagon this last year.
Cool.
Yeah, I was talking to him about that too. Next time we got a good hip hop show, we'll put them on as an opener.
I dig it
for sure.
Right now, we're going to watch our sponsor's commercial, Evergreen Apothecary, and then we're going to get back into a little bit more of their stuff and what's going on next door. I was just over there about 30 minutes ago,
something like that.
Yeah,
we got Chad in the house.
Hey yo. What's up?
From Evergreen Apothecary.
Hell yeah.
Here's our ad.
Here it comes.
World viral.
My connection.
Come to Denver's premier dispensary, Evergreen Apothecary, for all your medical and recreational marijuana needs. Located just south of I-25 on Broadway, only two doors north of Herman's Hideaway, Evergreen Apothecary.
God, dude, I suck. Here it goes again.
World viral.
Come to Denver's premier dispensary, Evergreen Apothecary, for all your medical and recreational marijuana needs. Located just south of I-25 on Broadway, only two doors north of Herman's Hideaway, Evergreen Apothecary has many quality products to choose from. Buds, edibles, transdermal patches, drinks, lotions, and we are also a flagship store for the world-renowned Open Vape, a personal vaporizer that everyone loves.
It's what's inside that counts.
We pride ourselves on the highest customer service with knowledgeable bud tenders that match every customer with exactly what they need and want. Come to Evergreen Apothecary on the northeast corner of Broadway and Iowa and mention World Viral TV to receive an additional 10% off your entire order. Now serving everyone 21 years of age and older. Open 10 to 7 every day. Evergreen Apothecary, South Denver's finest medical and recreational cannabis center.
Herman's Hideaway, on the corner of Iowa and Broadway. Your favorite independent anti-corporate venue, featuring Westward's best patio. Now serving award-winning food. From metal to jazz to hip-hop, Herman's Hideaway has something for everyone. And if you want to book your act at Herman's Hideaway, email booking@hermanshideaway.com or call 303-777-2535. There's only one venue, family owned and operated for over 50 years. Holding it down in Denver. Go to hermanshideaway.com for more information and show listings.
And we're back here on World Viral TV. My name is Moose. Chad. We've talked a little bit about these $99 ounces, man. What else is going on over there? Because I was over there and it smelled pretty damn good.
Dude, there's some really, really dang stuff we've been popping off lately. But one of the coolest things that's a brand new product, I don't know how many other shops might have it, but since we're the flagship store for Open Vape, which is this guy here, the personal vaporizer, they actually, we were only
here,
doing...
hold it up.
Here you go. Really, really sick. And like we have like small, medium, and large cartridges for them. But, and this is just like the little cartridge right here, and they come preloaded and disposable, right? But the small ones were that are butane extracted, they were only butane extracted for the small ones. But recently, our lab just started making strain-specific ones that are actually CO2 extracted. So you get more of the terpenes, more of the flavor, more of the strain-specific. So if you want a sour diesel, you can get a sour diesel if we got it, you know what I mean? So, and we didn't have the small ones. The small ones are only butane extracted, but now we have the small ones that are CO2 extracted, which people like because of the flavor a lot. So
okay, right on.
For sure.
And go ahead.
So do those actually come apart, or do you can you put, say, a different type in there, like shatter or hash? No,
so this one is actually preloaded with just honey oil that comes straight from the lab. There are other ones that you can use shatter and hash. Like we have a Go Pen. I'll have to bring my Go Pen one time. It's just a one that you... It's like a personal mobile vaporizer for shatter and stuff. This one right here, you don't really... load it with anything else. It comes preloaded. Yeah, for sure. But like they come with 100 to 200 to 400 hits in it, you know, depending on, you know, which size you get. So it's a really, really cool. Everybody likes it because you don't really smell it at all. I could hit it right here and it wouldn't even smell like weed.
Do they come in indicas and sativa?
Indica
varieties?
Hybrid and sativa. Nice. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So That's really cool. It's I heard a recent statistic on one of the shows we were on CNN at one time, and they said that one cartridge gets sold every 15 seconds in the state right now. So
wow, that's crazy.
Yeah,
wow.
That's a lot.
That's a lot. We just finished our. I think we had a hybrid cartridge at the house. Mm. That's we just finished last night.
Wrapped it up, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hybrids are awesome because they're just like good and stony. They just do. If you picture yourself stoned, that's what it does. Cool. You're not sleeping. You're not, you know, getting up and running around, being all trippy in your head. Good. Like, you're just good and stony.
Speaking of trippy, where is Ricky?
Yeah, right? That's a great question. I've gotten no response.
You don't have to have an answer.
I mean, the benefit of the doubt that we have to give to our early guests is that we start at 6 o'clock when traffic is like at its worst.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah.
And we're right on Broadway.
Traffic was really bad. Traffic was bad. There was an accident. I was worried that I wasn't even going to make it. So.
Well, you made it with flying colors and plenty of time.
I totally did. Well, everything happens for a reason.
Yeah.
I hear you. My commute here is pretty horrible too.
Yeah.
You know, I gotta walk around the back alley.
Yeah.
Knock on the door.
All 200 paces.
You know? What? I found though, I live out in Lakewood, and I found like a back roads way to get home from here when I leave at rush hour. Like if I go home at like 5:30.
Which way do you go?
Instead of taking
Golden.
285 or 6th.
Yeah.
I go on Iowa right out here out to Santa Fe and go left. Mm-hmm. And then I turn right on Dartmouth and go to Federal. Mm-hmm. And then go up a couple blocks to Yale and go left. And then it just goes all the way to Kipling.
Crazy.
Crazy. Alameda sometimes helps, but that's better when Alameda's all backed up.
Yeah, and Alameda's got a lot of lights.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't know how much time this route actually saves me, but it's not like I'm stopped in bumper-to-bumper traffic on 285. So even if it's the same amount of time, I'm like more at like a steady pace, so I feel like I'm beating the system.
Are there a lot of lights going that way?
There's more stop signs than lights, probably. I mean, there's like you obviously got Federal, Sheridan, Wads, a couple other ones in the middle, but I mean, you never really get up over 35 or 40.
But at least you're cruising along. You're not stopped and wanting to get out of your car.
Exactly. I don't want to kill anyone.
Totally.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Sometimes, like, coming over here this way, since I live in Golden, I'll take either 470 over to 285.
Okay.
But usually 470 is pretty packed to get to 285.
Yeah.
So I'll take Morrison over to Kipling and then Kipling to 285 to get to, like, the Inglewood area.
Yeah, I live off Kipling, and I like it a lot because when I first moved up here 5 years ago, lived off Wads, and it was like a damn shit show all the time. And I think Kipling is just far enough out that it's slightly less congested.
Yeah, Wadsworth is always congested for some reason.
Wadsworth and Colorado Boulevard, man.
I usually end up driving too fast on Kipling. That's one that, since it's kind of open, you know what I mean? You could just fly on it.
Yeah.
I usually do.
And Wadsworth, you can't. Or Sheridan, none of them. You're like, oh,
no. I mean, if there's not road construction, then you've got light after light after light. And they're usually packed in between. And
it's a labyrinth one way or another, you know? It doesn't matter where you go.
For sure.
Well, it's got to have one of those vapes.
Yeah, it does help. I mean, not that I would ever promote driving.
Yeah.
But if I did, I wouldn't have to use a lot.
What I'd recommend is pulling over at a park and then waiting for rush hour to be over.
There you go.
Dude, that's what you have to do in L.A. too, so Denver's not that bad.
Yeah, Denver's nothing compared to L.A.
Dude, so I was in L.A. before, dude, we stopped and got, like, food and got back on and still saw the same cars that it had.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
For sure.
Like,
that'll drive you nuts.
Totally.
It took me a total of almost 2 hours to drive 10 miles down the road in L.A. on the Sunset Strip.
You could literally walk.
I could have walked there. Yeah. I was texting my friend. I'm almost there. It says I'm right down the street. And 2 hours later, we were supposed to start 2 hours ago. I didn't realize traffic was this bad here.
I had a friend. I was stuck on the highway in Cali one time. I had a friend get out of the car, go and sit in the shotgun seat of a girl that was kind of hot at the time, you know? Got her number, came back, all in like 45 minutes, still like in that same mile.
Were they doing anything in there? Were they?
No, she was just hot. And then we were like, what's up? And they were like, what's up? And then he just like, watch this shit, dude. So he ran over there, got in her car, too. Like, they talked and got numbers and flirted and bloop bloop. Yeah, wow. Dude, he got her number. I think
she said lube, lube.
That's a pretty good choice.
Bloop bloop, you know, whatever. You gotta
throw
your
got the lube. Tim and I talked about lube today.
Yeah, we were talking about lube earlier. But I'll tell you the ballerest shit I ever did in my life. Probably. This was when I was in high school. And me and my friends were out at Taco Bell at like 10 o'clock or 11 on like a Friday night. And there's these chicks come in. We were inside eating. And these chicks came in, and they were fucking hot, and they were like our age, you know. And I went next door to the Cub Foods, which is now King Supers. This is further south on Broadway in Littleton. And I bought these flowers, and then we pulled up next to them on the fucking road, and I reached out the window and gave them to them. And then we fucking partied with them all night.
That is pretty baller.
That's
nice.
That's kind of crazy.
You know what? I had
to start.
Yeah. I had more game when I was 16.
Me too.
That's because we were constantly playing it.
Yeah, because I wasn't afraid to make a total ass out of myself.
Exactly.
Yeah. So what's wrong with that now? Why not have that same attitude now?
Yeah, I mean, all learn a lot from this whole conversation.
Really?
Yeah,
sure.
Just act like jackasses all the time. Let's stop it.
You're a total asshole all the time, you know?
Anyway, there was one more thing I wanted to ask you about the vape pen before we go to break here, sure. And that is... For someone who might not know or hasn't used one before, what are the benefits of using a vape pen instead of just smoking a bowl?
Well, I mean, it's definitely discreet. That's number one, first and foremost, dude. You can kind of anywhere that you want. You're not obviously not supposed to, but I mean, I've known people that have hit it in an airplane and nobody even knew about it. Like, I've hit it in bars myself. Like, I hear the stories all the time. It's almost like a game to see where the hell they can hit it at, and nobody knows. Everybody's like, it's just a nicotine pen, whatever. Obviously, that's probably the most popular thing, but I mean, you don't have to use a lighter, you don't have to pack a bowl, it doesn't get dirty when you tap it out, I mean...
And it's supposed to be not quite as bad for you, right?
Well, I mean, supposedly, that's what they...
Instead of smoking something?
There's not the carcinogens affiliated with the lighter and the plant material and all of that stuff. I mean, it's all sucked out, so it's... And, I mean, the CO2 extracted ones, like I was explaining earlier, they're not as harsh, so typically they don't make most people cough as much. It's a little more smoother, it's a little nicer on the lungs. You know, the butane extracted ones are still supposed to be a little bit less carcinogen than a regular bowl. Some folks think that the butane ones are a little bit more harsh, but some people love them more than the CO2 extracted ones. So, I mean, either way, whatever extraction method was used, it's supposed to be a lot better, more healthier. I mean, I kind of compare it to bud anyway, because it's not like wax or shatter where it's like, an amp up fourth to sixth gear. You know, it's more of still just chilling.
It's just a mellow. That's what I've noticed about that pen and why I like it.
I love it.
I'm like a one or two hitter quitter anyways. You know, I hit the pen and I'm just like...
We have people that come in and they're like, this is like the best thing since like cell phones. Right. You know, I had an older dude from another state come in today, and he's like, I just got in town, you guys sold me one of these, I am on my way out, but I have to get at least one more of these things because it's the best thing since sliced bread. I'm like, hell yeah it is, you know.
What's the percentage of the THC ratio?
Well, it all kind of depends. Obviously on the sativas, we have some cartridges that are up to 33-35%, which is just insane. You know, obviously a shatter is going to be well over the 80s, sometimes into the 90s, you know, so that's definitely a little bit different. But for a 30% or hanging around your neck that nobody can smell,
right?
You know what I mean? And that's obviously like the sativa dominant hybrids and the sativa cartridges. The CBD levels on the indicas have been really nice also.
So you do have some that have more high CBD qualities?
More CBD, it has the qualities, but it's not like high percentage of it, you know what I mean?
Just a little bit more moderate.
Yeah. More people get into patches and lotions, and like we have Organolabs that does the Canada tabs for CBD rich and stuff like that too, so.
All right, well, we're going to go to break. We will be back here in just a few minutes. The boys from Resonance coming on the program. Ricky Trippi is going to show up one of these moments.
When he decides.
Yeah. All right, well, stick around. We'll be back with more on World Viral TV.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. please us all. You keep your opinions where they belong.
told me. You find yourself a nice girl, yeah. Or you end up lonely, or you're lonely. Hey! I always thought she was telling lies until I seen those electric eyes. Now I'm changing up my story.